What's up, everybody? Welcome to day 285. Making Songbringer! Da 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 da! Today I'm making this old store. Man, I just threw this all together so long ago. This guy that looks like death selling you items. Who the hell is he? I don't know. Today we're gonna make this a lot clearer and a lot more beautiful, too. What's up, Lime Studios and Boogie? Yeah, early today. I'm trying to get the new year started early. Almost got a year by it, too. His name's Pete? I never knew his name was Pete. Christmas break was awesome. Yeah, New Year's was so great. Just got off a good little rock climbing trick. He's just trying to make a living, right? Yeah. I am going to switch all this up, though. It's going to be totally different. One of the suggestions a long time ago when I first made this was to make this a vending machine. And I thought it was a nice, funny idea, right? But it didn't quite make sense with this world, right? That it would just be a vending machine there that's all small. But I thought, well, if it's a gigantic vending machine, like this ancient monolithic type vending machine that works off some old technology, then it could work. What's up, Pedro? Happy 2016 to everybody. 2016 is here. I'm still trying to think it's not 2015 still. Chaos, what's up? You got a new phone? Sweet, man. The game's going great. There's going to be an alpha update next week. I was hoping for this week, but there's so many little things I want to get in. And so there's going to be an alpha update to the game next week. Yeah. All right, so I'm going to start turning this art. I'm going to start drawing, basically. Let's get this going. I took a screenshot of this whole scene without the lighting, so I got something I can start. So we're going to work on a mock-up image here of this vending machine. Giant's vending machine. I need my colors for pillars. I'm gonna do this with stone, I think. So I'm gonna grab the raw image for a pillar. That's like a good granite type color. Oh. Nice. Cool. So now that you've had a chance to really play your controller a while, how are you liking it now? Chaos Gaming, is it too late to pre-order the game? No, not at all. Yeah, there's lots of different pre-order options, and they're all going to be available all the way till right before the game is released. So you got plenty of time to pre-order, and it's always songbringer.com/pre-order, and you can check out the different options. There's three different options. So, you started one game a month? Sweet! This month's theme is hobby. Cool. Sweet, you got a PS4? Nice. Nice, man. Do you get any games with it? What you been playing? All right, now I got these colors. I want to get a little inspiration too, though. Let's get something. First, let me save this as some kind of mock-up image. Rocket Bunny! Welcome to 2016 to you too! Started playing Dark Souls. Wow! Okay, so you feel like you're actually a better player at some games with your Steam controller. Huh. That's good to know. Should I throw this one? Probably raw sprites, backgrounds. This is just like the vending machine mock-up. It's called vending. What's up, Red Sands? Okay, so a little inspiration. I want to go look at some vending machines. I want to make a giant vending machine out of stone. So let's look at some regular ass vending machines for inspiration. Wow, that Skittles one. Okay. Oh, PS PlayStation 4 has a TV mode? I'm sure it does. Nice, Chaos. Right on, man. Yes, Pedro. Such a cool concept. All right. It's not gonna be nothing like these, so this isn't really helping. Oh, PSTV is a console. It's a separate one? Whoa. Yeah, no, it's not gonna be a Japanese. It's not gonna be. Well, it's gonna be. I guess it is digital, but let's just see what happens when I start drawing. Maybe things will change as the concept gets a little more developed. First, let's add some texture over the top of these. Make this a layer. Pistons and gears. Yes, totally. Huge stuff instead of like small stuff. Rocket Bunny. Dude. Nice points. Bye, dude. Thanks for holding down the store for so long. Okay, next layer. Let's start drawing. I'm gonna start drawing some big old like columns. Well, first I'll grab make a palette. How's my New Year's? It was so great. Yeah, we saw some good friends. We had a nice dinner out, and then we had a great weekend too. We went rock climbing, just had a nice campfire and all that. Was an epic weekend. My girl even went rock climbing. She did good. She went all the way to the top. What was your New Year's resolution? What is everybody's? Mine's just to finish this game. Rocket Bunny's is to finish the game too. Oh, you can choose to procrastinate or work on your thesis. Dude, this is such a great game. Nice. Your New Year's resolution was to make a resolution? Good job, Woogie. You already got that done and settled, man. Nothing else to do there. All right. Oh, old cigar vending machines? I've never seen those. Whoa. I never knew they had these. What's that? Oh, that's awesome. You're gonna try and get to the top of the leaderboard. Was that your resolution? Study J Japanese, finish arrhythmia. Cool. Eat, sleep, play football. Nice. Participate in the next 12 one game a month challenges. Finish your thesis, get a job. Sweet, man. Pedro's shooting high. Anyone take advantage of the Steam sale? Oh, God. I know, I was out of town. I missed it all. You got Fez, Super Meat Boy, Risk of Rain, and Spelunky for like 10 bucks. Yeah, I figured Fez would be, and I got Super Meat Boy in the last sale last year. What's Train Jam? It's a collection of developers traveling via train to the game to DDC. Oh, wow. Sweet. I've never heard of this. This is so cool. Wow. What a sweet thing to do. You'd probably meet some people so well here at this thing. You definitely, if you're looking to start a team or something, man, that's, or just make friends in the game dev industry. That's cool. Right, so starting with this color. Kind of imagining what this is going to turn out like. You would be the youngest person, I'm sure. Oh! Can't stay 12 forever! You're turning into a teenager! The times are changing! Rocket Bunny's turning 13, everybody! Have I been watching the Games Done Quick? No, I haven't. I do, I've been totally busy. I've been on the road the whole time. I've been out in nature, man. Doing climbing mountains and stuff. With my friends. But yeah, I'll definitely watch some of them. I always seem to catch them on YouTube anyways. So I'll go back and watch the ones that like are super interest me and stuff. Thinking this is going to be about the size of this. Giant ass vending machine. Bam. About that big. 1 year closer to drinking beer. You're 13? You just turned 13, Chaos? Whoa. That's so great. Oh man. Whenever we chat and stuff and I find out how young you guys are, I'm so excited for you because you have so much at your fingertips that was not at our fingertips when I was your age. When I was your age, it was way harder to find information. Now, whatever you're wondering and whatever you want to learn, Chaos Gaming, Rocket Bunny, whatever it is you're into, you can go watch YouTube and like see people doing it for real. You can go like find people live on Twitch doing it for real. It's amazing the day we live in. You can find out anything on the internet. Please welcome our newest followers. Noctanis, Saruman, Yurapako, Jack, Kajak, Mothman, Blue, Snowman, Roxarovich, Wraith, YZZ, and Tom Peach. It dispenses asses? Yes, this is an ass dispenser. Butt cheeks, just falling down these shafts. Butt cheeks and shafts. Oh, this is getting really, really bad. Add Thor's hammer to the vending machine. All right. Yeah, that's the thought, right? It's gonna slide down these are, I guess they're shafts. There's like a shaft of rock, but like, yeah, the inside here, like, let's get a darker color. Here, that'll work. Basically, there'll be like these indentations here. You know, approximately like that. These are just going in the wall, and there'll be the item sitting here, and it'll be on one of those twirly things. And so when you select an item and you purchase it, the vending machine twirls out its spiral thing, and then the item drops to the ground. So the item will end up here, and it'll fall like that. Like a bank tube. Butter Broham, when is it releasing? This year. Probably summer. Probably, we'll see though. Right, pipes. Gosh, the pipes idea is really cool. But that's going to be way more complex with the art. Need to get this background a little bit more fixed up. Left it go? What's that? Somebody going for the ultimate or something and they're just not quite making it? Oh, from Frozen? X-Pixel, what's up? You ha-ha'd out of that stream as soon as that song started happening? Is it Frozen, that little girl's movie? It's like an animated movie for my nieces, basically. That's all I know what Frozen is. All right, there we go. This is the best movie ever. Yeah, Chaos, see you, man. Yeah, I'll be here tomorrow. Star Wars hype. You're making a life-size BB-8? It's a poisonous movie. Definitely don't watch it. All right, good. Glad I haven't seen it. Mute the whole movie, though. What's this, Pedro? This link? Oh. I don't know. It looks like a dangerous one to watch. Oh, mute it. Mute that. Oh, let me start playing this. Well, I'll turn off all the sound. I think I turned my sound off. Sweet, they're climbing a mountain. This can't be that bad. Oh, she's just gonna start singing, though. I think she's gonna start singing. X-Pixel. Lime, what's Zach Bell's Slack for game dev? What's that? Tell me what this Zach Bell Slack is. I know who Zach Bell is. The movie kills you on the inside. I'm even gladder. All right, so let me get some lighting on this whole scene to make him look more like it does in the game. And we probably need a little more room for this too. Yeah, I know the dude. It's a Slack for game devs. We have like 140 or so game devs on one Slack. What's a Slack? Sorry, I'm so clueless about stuff. But I don't know what a Slack is. Is that on Slashdot? Or no, it wouldn't be Slashdot. What's Slack? Is there gonna be a mini boss for this area? No, this is not really a mini boss type area. This is more of like a area you go inside this cave and you can buy items. There's really no enemies. Maybe one of them will have a secret enemy or something like that. It didn't snow for you? What? Oh, it's a messaging board for Teams. Oh. Is it like. So it's not like Trello. Trello is like a. Okay. I guess I'll check this out later on. I don't know. Might be useful for something. I don't know. What does Zach Bell talk about on his Slack? Or what do they all discuss? Or, you know, what's so great about it? Troll item kills you. That's something I would like to add, actually. It'll be super easy. But maybe, okay, so maybe the troll item is it's the most expensive item in the game. It kills you as soon as you purchase it, but it gives you a slight percentage on your entire total. So like if, you know, when you complete the game, it shows you how your percentage of items you obtained, a lot like how Super Metroid would or Axiom Verge or whatever. So you can't get 100% without getting the troll item and killing yourself at least once. So that would mean that permadeath mode, you couldn't get it. Or you could maybe on permadeath mode, you could beat the entire game and then pick up that item and still get 100%. Right, get feedback and help with art and coding and all that. Cool. Awesome. What's up, Dumtard? Oh, cool. There's the sign-up form. Nice. No, it takes 1% away if you do get it. Now it's even funnier. Way to go, Zach Bell. Seriously, this is such a cool idea. I don't know. I don't know how he would do this. Like, I barely have time to just do a stream and make my game. Is he making a game right now? Maybe he's not making a game right now. Maybe that's why he has the time to do this. Cool. This is great. I mean, I'm sure being on this is awesome. Oh, here. I'm just gonna sign up for it anyways. I'll poke my head in there and say hi. Okay, so my email address, nat@wizardfoo. There, I've submitted my email to the game development Slack by Zach Bell, gamedev.slack. Artemis, what's up? Happy New Year. Happy New Year to everybody. Happy 2016. I wish for you all a prosperous year, whatever you want. I want your life to see it become reality. You just want no zombies? Whatever it is, just no zombies. Oh, he's Mickey Faraway. Oh, right. Gosh, how do busy people do this? I have a tough enough time making this game and marketing this game on a daily basis. Okay, let's get some lighting on this thing. Enough complaining. What am I complaining? What am I complaining for? Complaining about time? It's not helping. We need a gradient. Solid gradient. Or not a solid gradient, but we'll do a lighting gradient basically. Let's adjust this thing. Yeah, far away. I haven't seen it in a minute. Let me take a look. So you have the. Is this it too? Oh no. Oh, that's not it. Sidon. Zach Bell's Twitter. Let's check out his latest media. I don't know what far away looks like. Oh, Space Boy Games? Space Boy Games. Are they just going by Farah? Oh, this is Farah in the Eye of Darkness. Oh, right. Far away, far away. I remember exactly. I have seen some GIFs recently. Do I think I could have made Songbringer as well in Unity as with GoGoStudio X? Sure, totally. Yeah, I definitely could have done that. But what would have happened is my game, it would have probably ended up looking more like other people's games. Because Unity, I don't know, it's like, with GoGoStudio X, I'm forced to do everything kind of my own way. It's really a DIY style game engine. And I just think that if I had done it in Unity, I probably would have been looking online at how other people do things in Unity. I probably would have, ended on a few solutions where I use a certain technique, like for perhaps, color palette swapping or something, some other kind of, shader technique or whatever that had already been done before. So I like that I did this kind of all my own way and came up with the good shading and lighting and things like that that are kind of just my own aesthetic. Make that black, do radial gradient, reverse it. There we go. Now we're almost to what regular lighting is like. Scale it a little bigger. And, oh, they changed it to Farah. Oh, Farah is the new name of it? Oh, okay. Now it makes sense. I'm like, where is it? Okay, there. That's sort of kind of what like the lighting is like in this game. So we can just put that on top for when we wanna look at what it's gonna look like in the game, sort of. All right, so let's start drawing this wall thing. All right, see you, Pedro. Have fun, man. Oh yeah, all right, yeah. Yeah, if you've only been coding for a year, I wouldn't really recommend GoGoStudio X unless you've been coding in C++ the whole year, because you really need to know C++ well to do any anything in GoGoStudio X, because pretty much you have to code everything your own way. It's like, I mean, they do have certain things that are available for you like 3D and stuff like that, but you have to code it all. With Unity, it's nice because you can use their awesome component-based system and yeah, your whole game is already in any component system, so it's awesome. Unity is a great engine, and you could theoretically do everything you would do in GoGoStudio X with Unity. I mean, it's not like they have different abilities. It's just more that, I don't know, it's just kind of like doing GoGoStudio X, you kind of are forced to do everything. What's up, Clock? It's going great, man. Happy 2016. Nice. So you've been learning C++ for a month or two. Great. That's awesome. What do you prefer though? What language do you really want to use? Because sometimes maybe you've heard like, oh, you gotta learn C++ and all that, but maybe C++ is not your preference. I mean, maybe C sharp is or whatever. So what kind of language appeals to you? Let's try. Let's put a plop a couple pillars down over here. It's just like blocking the area out. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I wish you all a prosperous year in whatever way you imagine. Whatever is your prosperity, your highest excitement, your greatest dreams, all of it coming true. It's totally possible. Make sure it's a typed language. You do want to use C++. Nice. Yeah, you like the level of control. Awesome. And the speed. Unreal. Yeah, Unreal's C++. And it looks really professional. I really like that, the way the Unity looks so pro. I mean, Unreal. I haven't used it. I've used Unity, but I haven't used Unreal yet. I'm kind of wondering how good it is. I'm sure it's great. That's why you landed on Monogame? Cool. Oh, so you already know the language and you get to write the game kind of from ground up. Totally. Nice. Yeah, you know what? Sometimes that's the best thing is like if you it's just simply doing what you want rather than what you think you should. You know, like you think you should learn C++ so you can do a cross-platform game engine or whatever, but really you just want to make a game. That's what excites you. Yeah, so Boogie did Entity Foo. I gotta post that soon. He did a C sharp version of Entity Foo and he started his game. Boogie, what's the Can you post a link to your latest tweet or whatever on your game? Is that wait, first of all, is that the game you're gonna make? What it Yeah, you post a link, I'll follow it. It's pretty funky. Blueprints are sick, cool. It's so focused on blueprints though. Oh. Ah, okay. And the documentation's not that great either. Nice. Right on. Cool. Yeah. I definitely want to share your links. See, people in here want to know. Yeah, mischief. That's right. Cool. Way to go, Boogie. So yeah, this is Boogie's game he's working on. Day one. Nice. Dude, good start for day one. I love the art. I love the background art. And this is like water tower. Is that a water tower? It makes me think this is like a maybe a got an 80s aesthetic or something. I don't know. I like it. Whatever it is, I like the start, man. Yeah, water tower. Cool. Makes me really curious. I don't know what it is, but I want to know. Nice. So there's an Udemy course for you. Unreal. Cool. Yeah, sometimes all you need is that breakthrough to get yourself really comfortable with something. Once you've broken through, then you're golden. There, so that's maybe, yeah, that looks okay. Some pillars right there. Those will be colored too. So these will look more like, here, wait, let's put all these together. So these things will actually look more like this greenish color, because they'll be colored the like the level, like the rock color for that area. For basic stuff, cool. Third person power up. This is an Unreal tutorial. Oh yeah, it is. Nice. Right, yeah, you there's really sometimes there's like no reason to ever switch game engines. Once you're familiar with one game engine, I don't know, I really do think it's kind of a risk to switch. It's a time risk. It takes a long time to get used to a game engine. All right, I'm thinking there'll be some like switches on the ground too. So let's place these switches. Yeah, definitely. Stick at what you know best. Yeah. Oops. All right, yeah, that's good. That's enough room, I guess, for these little switches. Right, let's keep working on this overall stuff. I'll do details later. Ooh, I got an idea. Maybe the very top of the screen should have the item info. Fact, let me see how tall it is when you buy an item.
Yeah.
So the text part of this is about that big. I'm gonna copy this, put this on. So I do want to see this text during this vending machine. Like I'm thinking this, maybe this vending machine has some sort of like, digital display actually on top where it shows you what item you're picking. What if the item words were like a flip clock on top of the machine? A flip clock. What's a flip clock again? Flip clock, what's that? Oh, one of these flip clocks. Oh, right. That's cool. Makes it more mechanical. I would have to do a different font. It's a cool idea. Yeah, Artemis, really good idea. Yeah, making a game in Unity and making it in Unreal. If you could do that, you're gonna become like sort of a master, dude. Because once you've done that with two engines, then you've really got, not only are you familiar with both of them enough to do that, but you know what you prefer in both those engines. I would, dude. What a great idea. I can't think of a better way to go about that for you at this point. Like, what to choose: Unreal, Unity. Make a game of both of them, then choose. Like a vacuum tube clock. Vacuum tube clock. What are those? No way. Oh, these are pretty cool too. Awesome. So many ideas. Whoa. I gotta see this in proper pixel perspective. Proper pixel perspective. Oh man. I forgot. It's not drawing both the cameras when I'm taking those kind of screenshots. Oh. Window size tiny. Game programming patterns. Yeah, I think you shared this link when you started reading it, right? Somebody shared one like this a while ago. Game programming patterns. Cool. Oh my gosh, wow. The biggest challenge facing many game programmers is completing their game. Ha ha. Right? Oh, nice. What's up, Zynger? Welcome, 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 welcome. All right, so if this, there we got some text. Go to the vending machine. Engine architecture. Game engine architecture. Awesome. The theory and practice of game engine and software development. Awesome. Wow, that one's expensive. It's a $60 book. It's like college books. My productivity goes down to zero every time I watch your stream. Oh man. Sorry, man. Your friend had to buy a college book for $400? Dang. Oh, so it's a really in-depth one. Yeah. Starts with math. Right. Ah, cool. Put these into a group so I can easily turn it off and on. Let's get all these items on the screen too. So I'll go to HUD. Oh, actually, I think I got them all already. Yeah, I probably should get these. Let's grab some of these fresh. Not that you're complaining? Okay. I hear you, I hear you. Let's reopen the HUD. All right, what item? Bomb container, of course. This one. Make a group for items. All right, maybe the fire death cube or something. Here, I'll see the death cube or poison, whatever. Poison. Your productivity's been low because you can't straighten your arms? I don't even know if I should ask why. Is SOMWARE's environment completely procedurally generated, or do you make each room and generate it randomly by placement? No. It's completely procedurally generated. Yeah, there's some games that will actually, yeah, they'll just technically all they're doing is randomly arranging rooms. That's not the case. Everything is procedurally generated in this game, down to the tile level. That said, there are some rooms that are sort of preset, like this exact room right here, where you're gonna buy items in this room. It's got a very specific purpose. There's really not really any way to flexibly change it. So this kind of room is something that's not procedurally generated. It's just sort of a preset pattern. And then everything else, like the overworld, the dungeons, everything is all from the tile, from down to the actually each block of the game is thought up in a different way, you know. What are those mango things? Mango things? On the screen? What's up, VanillaNet? Happy 2016. Oh, you overworked him at the gym. Oh. Nice, man. Getting a good workout in? Everything I said was just procedurally. I'm a robot. I'm a procedurally generated robot. What if we all were? It sounds like the plot to Battlestar Galactica. Oh, yeah, on the sprite sheet. Yeah, those are oranges, not mangoes, but oranges. Yeah, that was originally the health in the game. So your health was oranges. Was it supposed to be sort of like a vitamin C type thing? You know, you get vitamin C from it, and it makes you more courageous because you're not fearing as much because you're not as high, right? So high is like vitamin C is like your come down helper. But demon's teeth are sort of more badass anyways, right? I'm open to changing that still. If there's some other better idea that comes out for how to represent courage. What's another item? You can always buy a demon's tooth, so let's grab that. Chicken nuggets. I just thought of drawing one of those. It would be so like little like lumpy and it'd be funny to draw one of those. All right, so now I'm gonna draw sort of the what the slots are, these like areas where these guys are gonna be, these items are gonna be inside. So I'll turn out the lights. Wall chicken? Ah. Oh, Castlevania reference? Wall chicken. All right, so they're gonna sit on sort of like these shelves right up there. Start drawing that so it looks a little more better. Okay, so let's make this look more like an interior. Interior wall. Wall chicken! Oh no, I'm out of bricks. Right. Wild chicken. Hey, what's up, Arch Danny? Welcome to the live stream, man. Hope you've been enjoying the YouTube videos. Right? I know, it's like, why? Same thing with like health used to be inside the in Castlevania, you always used to be in the like the lights and the candles and stuff. You'd get health from them. Cool. Thanks, Argenia. I hope it's really inspirational and cool to see the process of making games like this. Okay, so this is going to need a gradient going backwards. Like there's going to be light hitting part of it, but not all of it. So let's get these all selected. Here we go. Yeah, wall chickens. Oh, the candles were special weapons. Oh. It's been a while since I played. The last one I played was Aria of Sorrows, which was great. All right, so I'll put a gradient on top. Oops, make that. Why is it circular? There we go. Linear gradient. I want that on a new layer. Let's do that again. Gradient tool. Other way. There. All right, so each one of these is inside like a little vending machine style spirally thing. Basically, this is like a spring. Alright, so it's going to need a circle. It's like the spring's going to be maybe about that big. Maybe a little smaller. No, not that small. We got 20, 15. Let's make this like right in the middle, 18-ish. Yeah, the spring's going to be about that big. In the Unity Slack, we went from debug formatting to code styling to talking about physics for boobs and butts. Physics for boobs and butts is pretty important. It's one of those tiny little details that makes or breaks animation. Gosh. You should look at Archer. Archer's a great show for that, for watching the subtleties of animation. Maybe that's why I like cartoons so much. Just love seeing everything animated. Okay, so if I were to draw this thing, in 2D, it would be like this. What? Yeah, about like that. This is the discussion GIF, huh? Right? Yeah, they look a little too, we think it might be a Mario ghost with a nose. It's like, it was a little too balloony. You know? I'm thinking of how a natural boob bounces. So great. Man, what a great visual. Oh, wait, so this thing's gonna. You can try this on a black background. Turn that on. Yeah, I can't wait. Yeah. All right, as this thing it becomes more foreground, about here. Ah. Damn it. Drawing the wrong layer. Yeah, so about here to about there. Arch Danny, yes, the game will be released on iOS. Confirmed. Thanks to the Kickstarter backers. Thank you every once again, everybody, that backed the project because you made iOS possible and the game itself is possible. I know, right? Drawing on the wrong layer? You draw, you draw, you draw, and then finally realize you're like, oh, damn it. I'm on the wrong layer. There should be some kind of fix for that in Photoshop. Like, oops, the last 16 commands should have been applied to this layer. Android is not confirmed. Android is a hell of a different beast. There's so much work involved in going to with Android. So no, it's not confirmed yet, but it is still a possibility. There, I could get enough alpha funding to make that a reality, or get it ported or something. So I will be announcing that later, maybe next, sometime the next 3 or 4 months. How are we gonna handle the controls? Yes, on-screen buttons. There's really no other way to do it. On iPad, unless you got an external Bluetooth controller or something like that. So yes, the Bluetooth controllers will be supported, but just for your standard iPad or your standard iPhone, it's going to be touch controls. That's all there is. Oh, I guess yeah. I guess there's touch controls, or there's you can tap to a certain position or whatever. But that's just not how this game plays. This game is meant to play like a old school Nintendo. Or, Sega Genesis style game, something like that. So yeah, on-screen buttons will be the primary way to play the game on iOS. Yes, I know CocoaCDX can compile for Android, but it's still that's maybe a tenth to a quarter of your problems that you have on Android. One of the biggest ones is supporting so many different devices, and testing on so many different devices. Testing is far too underrated. It takes so much time to test your game and then perfect your game after all the stuff you found from your tests. So that's why it's a beast of a platform to handle, because it's just got so many different test cases. Can you connect PS4 controllers to Android phones? I don't know. Can you? Good question. Whoa, you can? Awesome. How to connect your PS4 controller to your Android device. I wonder if that works for iOS as well. Yeah, it just works over Bluetooth. I'm pretty sure that would work on iOS. Yeah, just because you just got some. I gotta get some just to have some to test this game with. What's up, Cujo Bam? Yeah, iOS and its limitations. Yeah, you can test using emulators, right? But here's today's philosophy question of the day. Is using an emulator to test your game the same as testing your game on a device? I think not. Bluetooth of iOS can connect only to other iOS Bluetooth. So no, you can't do PS4. That's lame. So why not? You got a Mac Mini? Sweet. Cool. Your resolution is to make an iOS app? Awesome. Game's coming great. Working on this little vending machine. Swift and Xcode? Yeah, of course. It's a great way to make your apps. If you're going to make apps for iOS, Swift Xcode is awesome. Okay, I got to make this thing start looking 3D. All right, so the spring itself goes down and up as it... Okay, so if it's that tall, and it's maybe only one kink of the spring is only like a quarter to an eighth of its height. Oh, but there's the item in there too. That's right. The item is a thickness of maybe, or height of maybe 12. So 12 pixels high times 0.618 would give you about its depth between each spring. That would be 12. Each is about 7 pixels deep or so, plus the 2 pixels or 3 pixels, plus 1 or 2 per. So that's about 9 per. Okay. So this part of this spring is going to end up being 9 pixels above where it is now. Whoa, ew now. This guy looks cheesy. I don't know if I like it yet. What a hard thing to draw with this perspective. Your idea will be to use Unity. Yeah, I know you can definitely de effectively develop iOS with Unity. Yes. Yeah, I've used it. It's actually Unity's awesome for publishing to just about any platform. It's so great. You develop everything in that in Unity and it and you can see how it's gonna look and everything, and then you just it's so easy to deploy to anything. So yeah, if your ideal is to use Unity, I would definitely recommend starting to learn it too. In fact, really, if you it might be better if you just if you're really interested in that, then it might be better to just skip Xcode and Swift and go straight to Unity because you're going to spend a lot of time learning Xcode and Swift. But if that's really what you want, you know, if you really do want to be at least know that, then you know, I'd recommend it. But if you don't need Xcode, just it's okay to skip it totally. Yes, yeah, exactly. You develop how you would on the computer, you're right there in Unity, and then you just port it to iOS essentially. And with a single click, it's like boom, doom, you're done. It's ready for iOS. And it's and what's great about that is it's also ready for like a bunch of other platforms too with Unity. So it's a develop it once, publish it to many platforms kind of engines called that's you know, that's what cross-platform is. And it's I It's highly recommend it, you know, having a cross-platform engine to start with. Okay, how is this looking? Is this even anywhere near right? All right, so I gotta get this. Maybe about there. Not maybe this one. You use the whole tissue box today? Dang. So why did I choose CocoaStudio X? No, not just that it's open source. Yes, that's one of the big reasons. I love CocoaStudio X because it's open source, but it's also because I'm already really familiar with it. I've already contributed a lot to CocoaStudio X and already have my own library set up so I can pre-build it and run it really fast. But yeah, because it's totally open source, I can go and change stuff, which I do have to do every single time I ever upgrade CocoaStudio X. I always go back and apply in a few of my own little patches to the CocoaStudio X game engine. So that you know it runs exactly how I want it to for Songbringer and then it's cross-platform. It's also one of the biggest reasons I use CocoStudio X is it's cross-platform and also C++. All those things are just totally me in a nutshell in my game dev style. So yeah, that's why I chose it. It's really kind of a personal preference type thing. How did it take PS4 controllers in Unity? I don't know. I'm not really liking this whole spring idea anymore. I was gonna have this thing twist and then it comes out, but I'm just not really liking the way it looks yet. Yeah, looks ugly. I didn't like how that turned out. I'm gonna turn these off, work on something else for a while. Maybe the backgrounds add some granity look to this granite rock. Have I heard of Aider? Of course I've heard of Aider. Yes, no, totally. I've been following Aider since the very beginning of Aider's project. They started Aider a few months before I started Songbringer. And yeah, I've always had my eye on it. In fact, they really taught me how to make a trailer. I watched one of their trailers and I'm like, "Man, this game got me so excited to play it." I emailed them right away and I was like, "Man, your guys' game is looking great." They never wrote me back or whatever, but I'm sure it's just 'cause they were too busy or whatever. But yeah, I've been following Aider for a long time. Definitely on my to-play games as well. I can't wait till it's released. Light shaders to the flowers? Yeah. That'd be cool. I think there is a light shader. There's already a light shader being applied, but I could add a custom light shader to just the flowers. Catalyst, yes, of course. Please post links. That's fine. Totally. What's up, PMC? All right, let me open my original document where I did this whole first scene. This was like cave squared. There it is. So this is at 8% being applied to the rock. This granite color, put it down to 8%. Whoops. Best trailer ever. Doana? Domina? Oh, yeah. I've seen some of their GIFs. Oh, man. I got to hear this with sound. Nowhere near ready for launch trailer.
In a world of ancient Roman gladiator.
I'll definitely check that out later on so I can get a good quality look at that. Nice, PMC. Upcoming games to watch for. No Man's Sky, totally. Yeah, see you, Lime Studios. Cool, PMC. I'll check the full video out later on. Open that in my browser. Back to Twitch. All right. So the one problem with this art here is that this is a sort of like a big wall of stuff. It's going to be weird seeing the item text right here. What if this item text was floating above everything? Kind of like how it does already in the game. This was like here. Yeah, I think it'll have to be something like this where this window will appear. That makes more sense. Yeah, and then one of these can kind of light up. All right, cool. This is the text layer. Looks a lot better this way. So this will like pop up when the player like walks over to this area over here. If they're on, well, let's say actually if the player is anywhere in that range of the whole screen, like this range of the whole screen, it'll just automatically show the info about this item and also how many diamonds it costs. Yeah, we need diamonds on here too. Do I know Megasphere? Of course. Yes, I've been following Megasphere as well. Anton Kudin's game. I played his demo. I haven't been following it since I played the demo. I mean, I've been following his game, but just not haven't played any future demos if he's released any new ones. Wait, what does it say when you walk into an area right now for this? Yeah, his shaders, totally. He's got great shaders. Definitely. He cheats though. You do realize he's cheating with his pixel art in the sense that the pixels aren't all pixels, right? Like, I mean, what would be a regularly sized pixel if everything were drawn at the same resolution? Can have many different like things. Like he rotates his pixel art and doesn't realign it back to a pixel level. So it's not, well, it's just totally an aesthetic. Why what? All right, cool. Hope I what I was just commenting on that whole. Oh yeah, no, I'm not saying it's yeah, totally yeah. And I'm not saying it's not beautiful too. It's an incredibly beautiful game, probably one of the most inspirationally beautiful, and also his animations are also incredible too. The way everything animates in Megasphere is so sweet. Like the way the doors open and stuff, like. He's a master. He's definitely a master. Only thing I don't like about it now is that it's all white. I want some of this text to be a different color. Maybe, oh yeah, maybe if this all this text was gray. Just trying to get the right color for this text. This is still a little too dark. All right, there we go. We got it. 69. Works pretty good. Maybe a little more saturation on this color too. Nah, that was too much. Saturation 5, 6. All right, there. Enough messing with it. Okay, I got it. So behind these items, there'll be some kind of like big old like slab of rock that gets pushed back, pushed out, like gets pushed out. When you purchase an item, you step on this switch, it takes your diamonds, it pushes out the item and it falls on you. Yes, the game gets released this year. This game, Songbringer, yes, I'm so excited. This is what everybody kept asking me. What's your intentions for 2016? What's your resolution or whatever? And all I want to do is finish this game. So yeah, I'm really, really excited to have it out. Have I submitted it to GOG yet? No, I haven't. Nope, I haven't done GOG. I'm focusing on the Steam page right now. Okay, that looks good enough for this diamonds text. Oh, wait a minute. Okay, so to start working on this part, make this look better. Right, let's do some etching on. Do some etching on this like layer right here. Why didn't that turn out the right color? What? Oh, it's because I'm on this layer. Ah, damn it. GOG's like another place that sells your game, I think, right? There's like GOG and what are the other ones? Just a place for going and finding it. It's like itch, it's kind of like itch.io and the other, all those other ones that'll sell your game for you. I think it's for me, it's more important to focus on Steam and making sure that is as awesome as possible. And then later, I think adding to GOG and other sites like that is better because I want people to be able to buy it from Steam mostly at first. You know, that's the platform I really want to focus on. Yeah. Whoops. Ah, there. So I gotta do this etching on top of everything. Yeah, Arch Danny, I know that's a good technique for drawing things symmetrical, but for this I don't want it to be symmetrical. I want it to be asymmetrical. So that's why I draw each side individually. And you know, sometimes it turns out that I draw things symmetrically anyways, but that's fine. I want that individual touch added anyways. True, Boogie. Agreed. That's their whole goal, right? All right, Arch Danny, see you, man. Thanks for dropping by. It's a bit too. Yeah, that's better. Dog's pretty awesome. Nice. What is it about GOG that you prefer? Over something like Steam? Like what's a comparison? All right, so just to save time, I am going to flip it and mirror it. But then go and actually customize it out a little bit per pixel. Yeah, just work on this little etching. Let's connect all these and then break them apart differently. Whoops, wait a minute, I got the wrong color now. Gotta turn off the lights. Oh, damn it. I lost my color. All right, grab this color again. This time I'm going to draw it to the palette. Color lost. Songbringer canceled. Damn it. Sorry, guys. The game has to be canceled because I turned the layer off. I turned the layer off and lost my color. This is the end. This is the end, my friends. Yes. Oh, back in business. All right, Songbringer uncancelled. We're back. All right, let's put Put all these together. Opacity 100%. Now merge them. Let's call this the etching. That back 52%. All right, let's rough up the bottom of these a bit. That was too much. 2 pixels is too much here. All right, now what if this wall had a bit of sort of distressing looks on it, like some cracks and stuff? So if I take off that layer for a second, and I show the palette, turn off the lights for a second. And draw, let's see. So that was a tiny bit too much on some of this. It's too rounded. So, anybody just joined the stream, I'm just drawing this big old wall for a vending machine type of store. You go and you choose a switch and it dispenses you an item. It's an ancient machine left here by whom? With fully stocked with items too, isn't that great? Right, so what if we had a hole, a crack in the wall? Yeah, crack could do. Cracks. They're cool. Art day, yep. Yeah, the dungeons and the door glow, yeah. Yeah, cool idea, Boogie. Oh, let's do that right now. I'll do a little glow. So if this thing starts glowing... Yeah, that's a great way to show that an item is selected, right? The whole thing just lights up. Oh, maybe this thing can glow too. Like, hey, click me. Step on me. So we'll take this mode. Adjustments. Levels, here we go. Make this levels totally white. Is that right? Is that opposite? Is this opposite day? No, that's right. And we need some Gaussian blur. All right, this is getting cool. This glows too much. And it needs to be colored somehow. A medieval slot machine? Yes. I'm trying to go for that mix of the old and the new together. So hopefully that's coming through. This is the overworld we're talking about here. So the overworld is sort of like this really ancient, but still... You know, it's like technology level way better than ours today. It's like high technology, but it's such a high technology that they can use simple materials like stone or whatever to get what they want done. Kind of like from Stargate SG-1, if anybody ever saw that, Stargate SG-1, the way they did Thor's people, like everything they did was like rocks and stuff, but they always had holograms too and things like that. That's kind of the technology I'm imagining. What if this was a different color? Let's see. I want to keep it white, but I want to easily change the color. Let's do a hue layer. Can only be applied to... Whoa. It's not working. Why doesn't that work? That's that layer. Oh, there we go. So the whole thing would look like that if you had one item selected, sort of. Yeah, I can make it better. I can make it glow, the glow part look better for sure. I almost want to start making it, even though I haven't finished this art. But I think I should finish the art first. Okay, let's make this the glow folder. Glow. Put all this glowy layers in here. There, turn it on and turn it off. Oh, and it can get, oh, make this layer. Let's make this 60 again. Yeah. All right, next let's do these backgrounds for these. Turn off that, turn off the lights. Springs, I didn't like the springs at all. Enclave shadow, there we go. Turn that off. Let's move these items down a little bit, actually. That one. Move this item down to Yeah, about there. About there. Actually, that needs to be a couple pixels higher. Yeah, about there. Okay. Okay, so the backs of these have walls which push out. All right, so if an item is approximately, let's see, how big should this back be? If an item is approximately 10 or 11 or 12 wide, 12 maybe, it's gonna be, an item is technically 12 by 12 by 12. No, 12 by, yeah, 12 by 12. By less than 12, like how deep is 12 gonna be? 12. Yeah, it's about 7.5 times 2. It's gonna be about 15 pixels of height right here. That's 22, so this whole thing is just gonna be 7. Ah, wrong layer. And that probably needs to be darker. Oh, wow. Dang, I've been streaming for 2.5 hours already. Whoa. I gotta get going. Well, let me do a little recap then. Let's put in everything that needs to be in here. The lights. Yeah, so I'm working on this little vending machine store thing here. And yeah, I'm gonna finish the art before I go and start implementing it in the game. Oh wait, this needs that texture there. Sort of. That needs to be better. But anyways, yeah, that's approximately, you know, this is kind of what it's going to look like. You're going to come in here, you're the player. When you stand in this area right here, it shows you the information for one of these items. So, like, if I were standing right there, it would be showing me the information for this item. Maybe it moves this, let's move this text up a little. So it's sort of like aligned in the middle there. Yeah, that's nicer. Maybe even moving these containers up farther. Possibly. So yeah, it shows you the price and it'll show this glow too. Like that's kind of like the item selected or something. So that's what I'm thinking. You come in here, if you have the diamonds and you step on one of these switches, it purchases the item for you and it'll push out the item from its little enclave up here. And drop it on you, and you get the item. So it's like a medieval, futuristic vending machine. Yeah, so that's it for today's stream. And I'll be back tomorrow, getting back in the swing of things here, 2016. And yeah, that's going to be it for day 285. Make a song bringer. So cheers, everybody. See ya.